The World Wrestling Federation. For over 50 years, the revolutionary force in sports entertainment.
The question is, can this man take a DDT?
Question is, will he have to?
Oh, believe me, I know Jake the Snake Roberts too well. He's not going to get in the ring with this monster and not have a plan.
So many big matches on tap this Sunday afternoon. This one right up there with the top one, Spring. The Undertaker facing Jake the Snake Roberts. What a matchup that's going to be.
Well, like I said before, Jake the Snake has had snakes. He's had cobras. He stood behind a curtain with a chair. He was going to take out the whole Macho family.
Yeah, but Bray always sneaking up on somebody.
That's right.
This Sunday afternoon, he's going to have to face this guy, look into those eyes, if that's possible, and try to survive the onslaught of The Undertaker. I don't know whether that's possible or not.
Well, he's done over 1,000, tens of thousands of sneaky, low-life, no-good things. Right, Monsoon? And I bet at WrestleMania he's going to come up with something else, because you're not going to put Jake the Snake Roberts out just like that.
Well, it's all going to happen this Sunday afternoon at the Hoosier Dome. If you want to be part of it, only one way to do that now. Pick up that telephone, call your local pay-per-view company, and take advantage of the situation. Be part of history. Be part of WrestleMania 8.
Just like I was saying, here's the brawler. He's 245, 255 pounds. He's no slouch. He's a street fighter.
The great from the World Wrestling Federation certainly looking forward to returning to the Boston Garden for live action. The date will be Sunday night, April 26th. Indeed, make your plans to join us and you'll see the best in WWF action live in the Boston Garden, Sunday night, the 26th of April.
Nobody gets up with that.
It'll be the DDT versus the Tombstone. Who can slap it on the first?
And look at those eyes. The Grim Reaper headed for the Hoosier Dome.
にとってこの一戦は千載一遇のビッグチャンスであります。 WWF ビッグ3の一人アンダーテイカーを倒せば西川の株が急上昇するだけではなく、 SWS にとっても WWF にとっても重要なインパクトを与えることになるだけであります。本シリーズアンダーテイカーに相対する SWS レスラーはこの石川ただ一人。注目のシングル対決となりました。石川隆であります。
石川隆。
石川がコールされている。厳しい登場、石川隆。 WWF の超ビッグスター、ジ・アンダーテイカーの入場であります。墓場からの使者として WWF で悪の限りを尽くしたアンダーテイカーがついに日本上陸。昨年11月27日ミシガン州デトロイトでホーガンを破り、第18代 WWF 世界ヘビー級王者に君臨。その後タイトルはコミッショナー扱いとなったものの、アンダーテイカーの勢いがとどまるところを知りません。203センチ、145キロの巨体が今や遅しと赤とパープルのカクテル光線を間を縫ってゆっくりと入場してきた。サポートするポールベアラー、墓場からの使者アンダーテイカーであります。ゆっくりとした歩調で ーテイカーがコールされています。ものすごい男が、どでかい男が来日してきました。
はい、
何やら私もドキドキしてまいりました。今日のセミファイナル45分一本勝負、待ちに待ったジ・アンダーテイカー、菊池さんはどういうところを注目されますか？
いや、アンダーテイカーというのは実に実力のある男なんですよね。トップロープ走りもやりますし、はい、パニッシャー大志望ができた時もかなりいい技持ってましたからね、
はい、
ただこのキャラクターになってやはりズバリですね、不気味な感じしますよね。
まさに私どもこの実況放送席最前列でお伝えしているんですが、何やら本当に怪しいという一言であります。石川がこのジアンダーテカーをどういう風に仕留めていくのか。まあ、アンダーテカーは先ほど入場にお伝えしたんですが、203センチ145キロ、
はい、
軽々しいフットワークですね。背中越しにはウィズポールベアラーさん、このマネージャーですね、
はいはい、
ポールベアラー、
はい、棺桶担ぎ人というんですよね、ベアラーというのは。
まあ、そしてその本人アンダーテカーはまさに墓場からの使者。石川としては本当海のものとも山のものともつかないようなこの超ビッグスターというんでしょうか、 WWF でもホーガンの対極に位置する男とどうやって戦っていけばいいんでしょうね、菊池さん。
まあ、石川にはですね、かつての日本プロレスの吉村道明的な切り込み隊長的な要素がありますからね、
はい、
やはりこういう役は石川じゃないとまずいっていうか、石川が勝って出たんでしょうね。
まあ、おそらく SWS の各選手も石川とこのアンダーテカーの一戦を各自分の控え室でモニターを通して見ていることは間違いないと思います。まあ、一挙手一投足はご覧のようにゆっくりとした、菊池さん、技から技へのつなぎなんですが、その技自体のキレというんでしょうかね、
はいはい、
衝撃というんでしょうか、かなりのものですね。これは
字幕しても攻撃を受けても全然焦った色がないですね、まあ、顔色表情が全くないと言いますかね。
さあ、石川のここでサソリがどういう形でアンダーティガーの、まあ、いわゆる足というか下半身を崩していくのか。ロープに振ってあっと、アンダーティガーとそして石川隆、まあ、2人の動き、特にアンダーティガーの表情を見てますと、まさに喋ることを忘れてしまいそうな、そういった、
ね、
おっとこれだ、
これドン・ジャーディンって言いまして、
はい、
スーパーデストロイヤーってバスかぶってきたこともありますけど、
はい、
これはこの男の師匠なんですよね、
はい、
でスーパーデストロイヤーもこれやりましたけど、あれだけ見事に歩いたのちょっと珍しいですよね。
もう私どもは今放送席の手元のモニターではなく生の いわゆる私どもの肉眼でアンダーティガーの、あるいはマネージャーのポール・ベアラの動き、石川隆の動きを肉眼で見て皆さんにお伝えして
る。
ツームストンですね、今のは、は
い、まさに破壊石ですよね。
危ない危ない、カウント3。
55秒、そしてアンダーテイカ
ー、あっという間の出来事と言ってしまっていいでしょう。3分55秒、アンダーテイカーにその外貨が上がったわけでありますが、マキシさん、203センチの長身なのにものすごい体のバランス、そして
バランスもいいし、センス、はい、ジャンピング力もありますしね、あのキックも足がピッとまっすぐ伸びてますからね。
新潟のプロレスマンもあっけに。
Taker to join us and the Heart. Take a look, jam packed here in the home of the Toledo Mudheads, and here's a reason why. This guy, what a job he did just several weeks ago at WrestleMania, completely destroying Jake the Snake Roberts.
Well, he certainly did, Monsoon. My eye is killing me. Hit me with that magazine.
Gonna be a lot worse than that when the whole truth comes out, Brain.
Truth's gonna come out. It'll come out. You can bet on that.
Who on earth can stop the Undertaker? Did you see? Twice he got hit, and twice he got up.
He took two DDTs, probably the best DDTs I've ever seen given, and he just laid there and rose up.
I've never seen anybody get up from one. I don't suppose you would like to,
you wouldn't do that.
What? You don't know yet, do you?
What? What? Don't
I asked
don't
you several months
up.
Ago to find out what's in that urn that he draws all that power from, but...
They wouldn't tell me. They wouldn't answer me. They just stared at me like that. Good enough answer for me.
Maybe the negatives and the real photos.
We have the negatives and the real photos, and you know that. Why did they wait a month to make an explanation? Because it took them that long to doctor up those photos they're going to show.
You know why they waited, Brain? They waited till you perpetrated the entire lie so that the whole thing could backfire, so that now you don't have the title anymore.
You know what amazes me is this is the first time in WWF history that the champion is challenging the challenger.
Yeah, and why?
Because we got him where we want him.
Yeah, he slapped one right on the lips, that's why. Now she may have to go down and get a shot for hoof and mouth disease.
She lured him in.
We've got Fuji standing by with the berserker.
Undertaker, if you think you're tough, try him. Undertaker, they say you're unstoppable. Well, I'd like to prove that I can stop you if you got the guts.
Very good, make him stop, too.
Sound like an outright challenge to me, Brain.
Well, it is. You know, the berserker, he's a berserk kind of a human being, if he is human. And he wants to get his hands on a big man. He wants a big man. There's a big man right there. There's an odd man right there.
Be interesting to see what kind of strategy he could come up with. Fuji against the Paul Bearer. Here it comes. Tombstone City.
Oh!
Forget about it. Hey, ref! Wake up! That's what the Berserker's got to look forward to.
Can he pick the Berserker up and do that to him? I don't know. Jake the Snake Roberts at WrestleMania 8 2 weeks ago. He's on a roll. Well, it looks like this bag's for you.
They may need a bigger body bag for the Berserker. And maybe a double bag, one that could stuff Fuji in too. Special report coming at ya.
This week on WWF Superstars One-on-One, The Undertaker versus The Berserker.
This is our feature matchup.
Is scheduled for one fall. Come on down the aisle with
Budapest manager, Mr. Fuji, weighing 323 pounds, the Berserker.
This guy is just that. He is berserk.
The only man in the World Wrestling Federation that can control him is Fuji. Oh, this is going to be good, big man. It should be.
WWF fans are nuts for this man, The Undertaker and Paul Bearer.
You're trying to tell me they're dying to get in to see him?
I don't think I'm trying to tell you that, no. Standing ovation for The Undertaker.
You know where he lives, don't you?
Where?
Dead center of town.
I see. You know, there's a certain feeling you get when this man comes into the arena. I mean, it's a feeling of respect.
I don't know if I agree with you there, McMahon. It's a cold, clammy feeling that I'm not comfortable with.
But we're going to find out what happens here when the Berserker locks up with the Undertaker. The urn being given to the official.
How about that sword, McMahon? He cut the Undertaker up with that sword. You know what you got?
What?
Cold cuts.
Wait a minute. Fuji just grabbed the urn from the official. Undertaker now. Right from behind. Look at this.
Good shot.
And another one. Berserker with the shield. Fuji with the urn. Undertaker takes another shot. He won't go down. Undertaker hammered, and now he's down to the canvas. Wait a minute. What's he have in his hand? He has the sword in his hand. Broadsword across the back. Undertaker's down. He better get up. The Berserker's gone completely insane. Look at that. Oh, I can't believe that.
McMahon, I can't believe it either.
Undertaker moving just out of the way in the nick of time.
He tried to stick that sword right through him.
Collision, the Undertaker back. Oh, look at that, all the way over the top rope on his feet, out by Fuji. Yes, Fuji. Fuji just dropped the urn. Undertaker with his hands on the front of Fuji. Berserker from behind. This is wild.
You know Mr. Fuji's behind it. When he tried to
stick
that sword right through the Undertaker. Fuji is the devious one. He shows no sympathy.
Put a ring post and still on his feet, the Undertaker. Oh, no, look at this. Berserker exposing the concrete, bringing the Undertaker over. What's he going to do to him? Oh no, Berserker has him up in the air. Undertaker!
He'll drive down to the concrete. He's out this time, McMahon. There's no getting up from that. That was on the cement floor.
It's over. I can't believe that.
Finally, somebody's destroyed the Undertaker.
Fuji trying to keep Berserker back. Undertaker motion as Paul Bearer with the urn. He's getting up.
No.
He's getting up.
I can't believe it.
How can anyone get up after that?
This
he was
a power
drive down on concrete. The Undertaker stalking Berserker. Getting ever so close to the Berserker. Fuji backing the Berserker. Look at the look on that man's eyes. Yes.
He doesn't have the sword. He needs to get the sword back.
Fuji can't believe that the Undertaker is up. Berserker, Fuji heading back to the dressing room area. And Undertaker moving in right after him.
I've never seen anything like this, McMahon.
Oh,
look at that.
I can't believe it.
The Undertaker's going to join us.
And a special...
You're not off the hook yet, Brain, for some of those remarks you made about your mom. What a despicable person you are.
What's wrong? She gives me presents. I deserve it.
Hey, now look at this duo right here. I'm not sure either one of these guys had a mom.
Undertaker!
I'll tell you something, the Berserker's got his number. He almost took the Undertaker out.
Tried to skewer him.
Shish kebab to go.
Glenn Groove.
Fuji got a little bit bent out of shape after everything that the Berserker laid on this guy. He was still there, Brain. Still you know, ready to go.
He was piled dry on the cement floor. He kept raising up, like raising up from the dead. I couldn't believe it. Of course, like I've always said, I don't think the man's human. You know, Paul Bearer isn't human.
Well, that's for sure.
He smells funny.
He's got a funny, it's like formaldehyde.
Embalming fluid, yeah.
I could probably get you a couple of gallons if you like.
What would I do with it?
Pump it into your vein. What else?
You know, and he's so agile for his size. He's about 6'10". He's well over 300 pounds. And he's ice cold.
There's the urn.
What's in that urn, Monsoon? I've been asking you for months.
Why, you... You're supposed to be the broadcast journalist. That was one of your assignments, one of your jobs. Find out what's in there.
Well, I don't really like to talk to these two birds, you know.
The Nassau Coliseum on Long Island will host live World Wrestling Federation action Friday night, June 19th. And it is going to be most interesting to see if Ric Flair can regain the World Wrestling Federation Championship from the Macho Man Randy Savage. That indeed will be the main event of what should be a big WWF event Friday night, June 19th at the Nassau Coliseum.
Earlier on, we had a chance to talk to Fuji and the Berserker.
Undertaker, still walking. I want you to finish it.
Undertaker, next time, I'm not going to miss. Undertaker, I'm going to stand this in your stinking, white, cold, ugly flesh.
You know, he could have been describing himself there.
Something's going to happen on Monsoon. I'm telling you that right now. This
Undertaker. He didn't ram him with the horns.
He hit him with the shield, piledrived him on the floor, tried to shish kebab him, and the man is still in the ring. He's still standing, kept coming back. But if anybody can get this Undertaker, if anybody can hurt this man, it's got to be the Berserker. And what Fuji's going to do when he gets his hands on Paul Bearer, I can't even tell you what Fuji told me he was going to do.
What? I'm looking forward to that confrontation.
That's going to be a heck of a match.
What? This youngster here, obviously, in a lot of pain.
Whoa! Can you imagine being hit with that kind of force? And there he is. He's drawing his strength again from that urn.
A lot of these youngsters, Brian, don't have any idea. They signed those open contracts knowing that they want to be here in the World Wrestling Federation, want this kind of television exposure, but never know who they're going to meet. And now there he is in there with this awesome individual who's about to lay the tombstone on him.
Well, all these ham and eggers have to do is win one match, and it makes their career.
Oh!
But this isn't going to be the one, pal.
Or it could terminate your career also.
2, 3, it's over.
3,000.
I hate that music. It doesn't have a beat.
There's the body bag.
Hey, while you're there, Undertaker, put McGurk in the bag.
Why don't you stop? Give Mike McGurk a break. Let's go back and take a look at the awesome power of the Undertaker.
Look at this. Picks the man up with one hand and just jams him into that canvas. And look at this. Drops him right on the back of his head. This man is awesome.
And then stuffs you into that body bag.
This bag's for you.
Not a whole lot of air in there either.
Well, the air is his primary concern right now.
When they stick you in there, you're usually not breathing to begin with. Undertaker, a dangerous person. Special report coming up.
Ooh.
As well, the Undertaker. Along.
Aha. For whom the bell tolls. The Undertaker.
This contest is scheduled for a long time. Coming down the aisle with Paul Bearer.
He may be walking tall now, McMahon, but if the Berserker gets a hold of him and puts that sword right through the middle of him, he'll be 6 feet under.
Bill Pierce.
I am really looking forward to the matchup involving The Undertaker and the Berserker. And it could very well be that after the matchup, the Berserker would rest in peace.
Not a chance, McMahon. Mr. Fuji at ringside, the devious one. Oh, and is he devious?
Yes, indeed he is. I couldn't believe Berserker a couple of weeks ago trying to skewer the Undertaker, and that sword was just shimmering as it was stuck right into the middle of the canvas.
Well, maybe this time he'll be like a Vegematic and slice and dice the Undertaker and put him in a coffin.
Paul Bearer with the urn, and the Undertaker, Bill Pierce, with a forearm in the back. Series of them. Oh my goodness, the Undertaker hasn't even touched him. Hasn't even touched him, but no doubt, the Undertaker, such an awesome sight, such an awesome force in the WWF. Look at that. Whoa, down to the canvas. My goodness, the Berserker is going to be in for it. We had an occasion to speak with the Berserker and Mr. Fuji earlier on. Here's what they had to say.
Hush! Undertaker! Hush. We got to put you 6 feet under! Hush. Undertaker, I'm going to kick your stinking teeth in, shove you in a coffin, and put you back in a grave where you belong!
Yeah.
Hush! Hush!
See how Fuji loves that, McMahon? That's right. That's right up his alley.
Oh, he loves it, all right. If he shows his face at ringside, he could get the same thing the Berserker's going to get.
Oh, I don't know about that, McMahon. Fuji, he's relentless. He feels no sympathy for anybody.
Off the rope! Ah, big boot by the Undertaker. And again, the look toward the urn, and Paul Bearer, the possessor of the urn. Oh, yes.
Oh, McMahon, that makes me sick to look at that Paul Bearer. And talk about making me sick. How about the Ultimate Warrior last week? What a despicable act that was to get sick all over the place.
Hey, wait a minute. It wasn't his fault. I mean, there was nothing to be embarrassed about. It wasn't the Warrior's fault. Let's cut him some slack. We'll get a report on the condition of the Ultimate Warrior in the update. That, what we just saw a moment ago, walking that top rope, is very impressive.
Yeah, that's impressive, all right, McMahon. But I'll tell you what's even going to be more impressive is when he's laying on that mat and the Berserker's got that sword sticking right through him and the mat.
Unfortunately, things not looking too good for Bill Pierce. Down to the canvas. The Tombstone. And the Undertaker, once again, victorious. The Undertaker, along with Paul Bearer, chalk up another victory. What a matchup it will be. The Undertaker versus the Berserker.
Yeah, what a matchup it's going to be, but I'll guarantee you he'll never get the Berserker in one of those body bags, McMahon.
Let's take you now to the update.
Smartest thing the big boss man ever did, hang up on you.
Nobody.
But before he did, he said, I'll be back. That's good enough for me.
Well, nobody hangs up on me. He won't be back by soon. Nobody could take a beating like Nails gave him and come back.
Well, sounded pretty determined to me. If he does come back, he'll be the $6 million man. I'll tell you, they're going to have to finally put his money together. Then he should hear from the likes of you.
Hang up on me. That hip-hop, who does he think he is?
Well, folks, the Brain did indeed get hung up on by the big boss man, but tonight, when you're watching the big WBF championship, you won't when you call that WBF phone line and express your opinion about who should be the 1992 WBF champion. Pick up the phone and call the WBF phone line.
I'm surprised he never puts Mike McGurk in that bag.
Why should he?
She looks like she's dead.
Oh, please. Boy, she must have really did something to you, Ray.
Just tired of her begging me for a date.
I think it's the other way around. I think it's the constant refusal that's gotten to you. Berserker tried to make a shish kebab not too long ago out of the Undertaker. You know what? He didn't get the job done, and that could be his demise.
Well, I don't think he's going to be able to get the Berserker in that body bag. Berserker's just as big as him almost,
but not as smart.
Berserker's got Fuji.
That's what I said. He's not as smart.
But I don't know if you can hurt this man. Berserker pile-drived him on the cement floor.
Oh, he got hurt.
Ripped the pad up. But, I mean, he's back. He's standing there. There's something about that urn.
Yeah, I asked you 6 months ago to find out about it, Mr. Broadcast Journalist. No word yet, huh? Not even a clue.
Look at this.
Look at that. Powerbomb by the Undertaker.
One hand. One hand, he picks up a 230-pound man and just jams him into that mat.
What a powerhouse. The Grim Reaper on the forearm of this behemoth. How easily he just handles all this opposition. Well, latest edition of the WWF Spotlight Magazine will be available on newsstands everywhere this Thursday. And believe it or not, Brain, the whole issue devoted and dedicated to The Undertaker.
The whole issue?
The whole issue.
What a waste of paper.
In other words, there's not one picture of you in there.
Well, then it won't sell.
Probably be a collector's item.
I think Paul Bear's a collector's item.
Talk about things that are going to be hot and be collector's items. It's going to be a hot one in Long Beach at the Convention Center this Saturday night. The big one's coming up. The WWF Championship. All the marbles up for grabs. The event is sold out. Only available now on a pay-per-view basis.
Oh, don't forget, the total package Lex Luger is going to be guest posing for the whole world to see.
Who cares? The whole world. This one is over. The bell tolling indeed for Dan Robbins.
Look at this, Monsoon. Look at that. Hand right into the mat. Surprised you haven't broke someone's neck by now.
That makes you a lot shorter, you know.
Get in the ring at 6'1", you leave your 4'11".
Compacting of those cervical vertebrae. Later on in life, you're going to be paid dearly for that.
I guess this bag's for you.
Oh, that bag's for the Berserker.
Never get him in it. He'll just take his sword and cut his way out. You know, you whip by the bag, you might be in the bag. Maybe the Berserker will stuff him in the bag.
Berserker had his chance. Let him get by him. I don't think he'll ever be given that opportunity again.
Oh!
Event Center coming up. Here we go.
The following contest is
Razor Ramon. I suppose we'll be seeing Razor Ramon in action. That is, in action in the squared circle, hopefully, very soon here in the WWF.
Seems like a pretty cool dude.
Speaking of cool dudes, look at this. Standing ovation.
Take a look at that.
My
look at goodness.
That. Head on that one.
Yeah, I'll say.
He might look a little bit different after Mr. Fuji and the Berserker get through with the McMahon. He gets that sword and sticks it through the middle of the Undertaker. He'll stay down.
Yeah.
what Vicky would, then again, I'm not too sure. I'm not too sure if any human being, if any human being can stop The Undertaker. He's almost supernatural.
I have to agree with you. I've never seen anybody come down the lane a long time that looks and acts the way The Undertaker does.
Ah, yeah. It's almost like a vice-like grip The Undertaker has. Look at that. Wow, down to the canvas. That could just as easily happen to the Berserker.
Mark my words, Mr. Fuji is the most devious man in wrestling. If there's a way to figure out to take The Undertaker down, Fuji and the Berserker, they're the couple of guys that can do it.
And take a look at this. The agility possessed by one of the biggest men in all of the WWF. The power from the earth down, crushing across the back of Dwayne Gill.
Wow, is that impressive, McMahon. I'm Mr. Perfect. I'm going to tell you right now, that's not an easy task to walk across the top rope like that.
Especially if you're around that 300-pound mark.
Exactly.
Whoa! Way up high! Unbelievable agility possessed by The Undertaker. And there you see The Undertaker on the cover of this month's edition of Spotlight Magazine. The Undertaker, the Grim Reaper of Wayward Souls. And it looks like Dwayne Gill is going to be a wayward soul. Nobody gets up after the tombstone. Nobody.
Not yet.
Not ever. Undertaker, victorious, and henceforth, the body bag.
I'd like to see the Berserker take that sword and use it like a Vegematic and slice this man down to size.
And I'd like to see either Berserker or Mr. Fuji leave the ring area snuffed in a body bag.
Insurance, that is. There's also something known as burial insurance, if he's lucky enough to have some of that.
Doesn't look too promising for Bruce Mitchell, that's for sure.
It doesn't look too promising for anyone who steps into the ring with Paul Bearer and The Undertaker.
Oh, that's where you're wrong, McMahon. There's one man that can stop The Undertaker and Paul Bearer.
And that might be
the Berserker and Mr. Fuji.
I see. Well, now I think this opponent of The Undertaker, Bruce Mitchell, may be having second thoughts now that he sees the size of this awesome athlete. This man who is so awe-inspiring, just his presence alone. Although, you know what, you take a look at Mitchell, you can see the fear in his eyes. Oh, my. Oh, my. And the clutches of The Undertaker!
My goodness. One-handed over his head.
Paul Bearer likes what he sees. Urn has a few dents in it.
What a weirdo.
Who?
Paul Bearer.
Well, he's a little strange, I'll grant you that. Right about now, Bruce Mitchell is saying, what did I do? Why did I sign on for this match? and what's going to happen to me. Uh-oh.
Undertaker, all 6 feet, 9 or 10 inches, whatever he is, on the top rope, walking the top rope, and from there,
down across the back.
I have to admit, that's perfect balance up there.
Mitchell, at this juncture, I would have, here it comes! Burial insurance is paid for! An easy victory for the Under.
Wait a minute.
Hey guys, wake up. Here comes the Berserker. What's he doing down there? He has no business down at ringside. The last, look at the salt right into the eyes of Paul Bearer. The last time Berserker was down at ringside, he tried to skewer the Undertaker with his sword.
I told you, Mr. Fuji would figure out a way to beat the Undertaker.
Fuji has the urn. No, wait a minute, the Undertaker has Fuji. From behind the Berserker. Berserker hammering away on the Undertaker. Undertaker still coming at him. Berserker with roundhouse rights. Undertaker just stared him down.
Doesn't even register a McMahon.
Look at this. Yes, has him by the throat. Fuji's coming back into the ring. Oh, yeah. Across the back with the cane. Fuji is going to get nailed by the Undertaker. Fuji runs from the Undertaker. Berserker's on the outside now.
He's got something in his hand.
Oh, no. Salt into the eyes of the Undertaker. Berserker and Fuji have done their dirty work.
Still up.
Even the salt in the eyes had hardly any effect at all.
For whom the bell tolls, and that bell, I think, is tolling for the Berserker brain.
Well, this guy shows up at my picnic with $1,295. He's not getting in.
I can't believe you're charging people.
Can't believe I had it 1 year and didn't.
Where's your spirit?
Did you see the way the Berserker last week cut Okerlund's tie in half? So clean, so neat, just like that.
Don't sell the Undertaker short, Brain. He could put you in a deep freeze in a hurry.
I can see that tie going, and maybe the brim of the hat, too.
Of course, but the Devious One, I think, is a little bit more dangerous than Paul Bearer is.
Oh, definitely.
Me even asking about the urn. I guess the broadcast journalist did get the job done.
I'm not going to ask about the urn. I'm going to be playing simple with you. I don't care what's in the urn.
Well, you are playing it simple now that you mentioned it.
Look at those eyes, Monsoon.
Did you ever see him smile?
Smiling right now is the happiest he's ever been.
You're kidding. Referee not wanting any part of that urn. I don't blame him. Who knows what's in there?
I understand he sleeps all day and he's up all night.
Like a vampire. Well, Bob Knight.
The basketball coach?
No, not Bobby Knight, the basketball coach. This youngster that's providing the opposition or supposed opposition.
Well, the way
for
he
the Undertaker.
I figured the way he coaches basketball, he'll probably show up here wrestling.
Whoa, look at that power display.
And he draws it from the urn.
dangerous individual to say the least, but he certainly will have his hands full with a berserker who we had a chance to talk with earlier on. Here he is.
Undertaker, the only thing I like to do more than slamming you on the cement, the only thing I like to do more than beat you up, is to take this stinking sword upside your head.
What a dangerous individual.
What a match that's gonna be. Both about the same size. I think the Berserker has the edge. I think he's a little crazier than this
guy. I think he's a lot crazier.
Well, this guy's not your run-of-the-mill Dun & Bradstreet guy, you know.
Look out, here it comes, Tombstone City.
Oh!
Neck adjustment time.
He just slam dunked Bobby Knight.
It's all over.
Respect of this gentleman right here.
Oh, you better respect him.
The Undertaker!
Undertaker keeping at the top of his game as the body bag has been brought in. They'll need a bigger bag for Berserker, Brent. What do you think?
Berserker says they're going to need a triple bag because he's going to put the Undertaker and Paul Bear in the bag.
Ooh.
Stuffed in there, and once you seal it up, there's not a whole lot of oxygen left as these youngsters are looking on, some of them in disbelief. Believe it, folks.
Hey, there's room in the bag for McGirt.
Special report coming up. Here we go.
This bag's for you.
Take a look, jam-packed here in Cornwall, for whom the bell tolls, perhaps for you, the Lordship Girls. So along with Alfred Hayes here at ringside as we take a look at Paul Bear leading the way down for the ominous one, the Undertaker.
Well, he's in shivers down my spine, and I certainly hope there's no bells ringing for me anywhere at the moment.
Highly unlikely, Alfred. You're going to be around for quite some time. Gill, on the other hand, I don't know, his days could be numbered.
That could indeed. That could be a very quick departure. We saw the face there of Paul Bearer. Now we look at the countenance, the very striking countenance there of the Undertaker.
The look of astonishment, the look of what?
Fear.
Fear.
Yes. Apprehension. And horror.
And the look of disgust.
Yes.
That was the look of disgust on Paul Bear's kisser. What kind of a look will be on the face of the Ugandan giant Kamala come August 31 at SummerSlam in Wembley when he has to step in and face this humongous individual?
Well, so far, Kamala, a very primitive man, has never ever shown any respect or fear or anxiety when he gets into the ring with anybody. However, it may be a different story here with this huge, huge, impressive man.
The only time I ever saw Kamala upset was when he missed lunch. Then he gets very upset.
Yes, I wouldn't like to be around him then.
Of course, he has lunch about 7 or 8 times a day. Still, no one knows what is contained inside that urn. I've asked the journalist, Bobby the Brain Heenan, on a number of occasions to find out what was in there, and all for naught.
Well, he doesn't want to get anywhere near Paul Bearer, or for that matter, The Undertaker. He's horrified of them both, and so am I. I don't want to ask him what's in the urn. Maybe you should do it yourself, Gorilla.
Yeah, well, I'll just go over there one time and take a look in there. What could be in there? Ashes.
Ashes,
you know, that's what you... What is it, Paul? Must have been something you ate.
These two have an uncanny knack of knowing what each other thinks, you know. You don't see Paul Bearer saying much to his man inside the ring. He just shows him that urn for a little force.
Well, he seems to gain power somehow from that urn.
that's possible. Well, it is, because that's what I've seen. He holds the urn up, he draws some force from that urn, and then he becomes impervious to pain, oblivious to anything else, and he just demolishes his opponents.
Well, what's Kamala going to do to gain power? Is Kim Chi going to hold up Dr. Whippleman and say, hey, derive something from this?
I don't think even that would satisfy the appetite of Kamala, quite honestly, that little fellow.
What a matchup that's going to be, along with the big one, of course, WWF Championship on the line, the reigning champion, Macho Man Randy Savage, against former WWF champion, the Ultimate Warrior. Holy mackerel, what a bout.
What a collision. What an incredible collision that's going to be.
All the marbles on the line at Wembley Stadium. Going to be jam-packed to the rafters, Alfred.
Well, we know that.
I hope you didn't promise a lot of tickets to all your relatives over there.
No, I didn't do that. It rather took me by surprise, though, that we would sell all those tickets in just 10 hours.
Oh, amazing. Uh-oh, here it comes. Tombstone City. He'll be hard-pressed to get Kamala up like that, but it wouldn't surprise me. Obviously, The Undertaker right on top of his game. There it is.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall.
New York, you're on soon along with Alfred Hayes, bringing you this tremendous matchup. Take a look at that
Skinner.
Disgusting pig Skinner with that tobacco juice running down his face, Alfred.
I can't listen to the things you say about this fellow. I mean, you hold nothing back, do you?
Well, look at that. Would you want that walking into your living room or your kitchen?
No, that is revolting.
Or
there,
coming to pick up your daughter?
No, that is revolting. And at the same time, I wouldn't like this man coming into my kitchen to pick up my daughter either.
Six of one and a half a dozen of the other.
From Death Valley.
You smell that formaldehyde, Alfred? I do.
Oh my word, this fellow strikes a chill right down my spine.
Where's the big news? Everyone talking this past Monday night in Worcester, Mass. World Wrestling Federation tag team belts changed hands. Money Incorporated was defeated by the natural disasters, earthquake and typhoon. How about that?
I think that's a shock. It really surprised me when I heard that news. But I must say that if ever a tag team deserved that title, the natural disasters were number one, in my opinion.
Obviously, Lord Chip Money Inc.'s game plan must have failed, or they couldn't find a way to get out of the building.
Well, something went down the drain there for Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart's men, because I really thought those three had blended so well together, all their considerable talents, and it would take dynamite to dislodge them from those belts. But natural disasters are obviously more powerful than dynamite.
Obviously they are. They learned a lesson at the Hoosier Dome. They knew what to expect. They knew if they got Money Inc. in trouble that they would probably try to hightail it out of there, and they found a way to circumnavigate that.
They did indeed, and just look at Undertaker. He's mesmerized by that copper urn there that Paul Bearer so gingerly carries around. I'd like to... Oh, that is a terrible, terrible thing to do.
Who knows whose ashes are in?
I don't know. There might be something else in there. Who can tell? Nobody whatsoever.
He just smacked the Undertaker with the alligator claw or paw or fist or hoof, whatever it may be, and it didn't faze him a bit.
No, and that has shocked Skinner. Skinner's told the people with that before, and they've gone down straight away. Undertaker took three or four great hits with that claw and didn't, as you say, didn't faze him one iota.
Well, we keep, Alfred, getting more and more matches as every day goes by for the big SummerSlam event in Wembley Stadium. And now I understand, signed, inked, this guy we're looking at right here, The Undertaker, will face the Ugandan giant, Kamala.
How big man, a big, big, dangerous man, Kamala, with his entourage. And surely he can be somebody who would face The Undertaker. A huge, huge man from Uganda.
I understand that Paul Bearer immediately ordered a larger body bag, Alfred.
No, he did that.
Because Air Africa would not fit. In fact, I think he wants a bag for all three of them to fit in. Kamala, Dr. Harvey Whippleman, that horrible excuse for a human being, and Kim Chi, that other piece of garbage.
Well, surprisingly, Kim Chi is the only man who can apparently get across the will of Dr. Harvey Whippleman to the Ugandan giant.
Are you kidding, Alfred?
Well,
Kim Chi doesn't even know what day of the week it is.
How does he converse with them, then? How does he communicate?
He carries the groceries, I guess. Just like a dog. When you want him to do something, you give him something. After he does it, you give him something else. With Kamala, it's always lunchtime.
Well, I would say, looking at that the other way, inside the ring, Kamala certainly has the abilities to beat Undertaker. They're primitive, his abilities. But he has such power, strength, and size, he could do it. And it doesn't look like Skinner's going to do it, that's for sure.
What a matchup that's going to be. Hope they reinforce the ring at Wembley. Uh-oh, here comes Tombstone City. Now you'll see some tobacco come out of there.
Oh, gosh. Look at that.
For whom the bell tolls.
Yes, a little RIP there for Skinner. And that bell does toll.
It'll be Big Ben tolling for Kamala. Here is your winner, The Undertaker. The very impressive Undertaker with his man, Paul Bearer. Looking forward to the confrontation at Wembley. Well, Ray, big news. These additional matches signed. You were wrong again, Brain. British Bulldog will be facing the Intercontinental Champion, Bret the Hitman Hart.
Now, there's politics involved there.
What do you mean?
Where's it being held, SummerSlam?
Where's it being held? In Wembley Stadium, in England.
Where's the Bulldog from? What country?
He's from Manchester, England.
I think the cards are getting stacked against Bret the Hitman Hart, which I don't really care. But just showing you
the way it's obvious you do care.
No, I'm just showing you the way Jack Tunney operates.
How about Undertaker against Kamala?
Well, you might see the Undertaker, Paul Bearer, and that urn all in one big pot of stew.
And Shawn Michaels to face the model Rick Martel. Wow, what a lineup.
This is the SummerSlam I thought I'd never see.
Well, maybe you won't see it. Maybe
I'm
you won't be
there.
There.
I'll be there.
Can you imagine? I can't imagine what it's going to be like.
Undertaker and Kamala. I mean, these are main events any place in the world.
I don't think Air Africa is allowed to fly over English soil, Brain. Well, then I think he's going to be grounded by one Undertaker.
Then Kim Chi and Dr. Harvey Whippleman will bring him in by steamer.
Oh, please. Those two misfits.
I'm going to tell Kamala what you said.
Boy, I hope so.
That won't do me any good. He can't understand me.
Look of determination always on the kisser of the Undertaker. And there's no describing the look on Paul Bearer's face. Ever. You know, Brian, that big matchup, that Intercontinental matchup, this is more than just a match. There's family ties at stake here. Big, strong family ties.
Well, there's a good way to look at it. If Bret beats the Bulldog, he don't have to buy the family any Christmas gifts.
Oh,
and vice versa.
Be serious, will you please?
Who cares?
Who cares? Don't you think for one moment that Stu and Helen Hart aren't concerned about what's going to happen at Wembley?
They're concerned where they live.
Oh,
they're nuts.
Why don't you be serious? Now, there's a job for you, Brain. How are they going to get that urn through customs over there in England?
I don't
Earlier
know.
Earlier on, we had a chance to talk with the Ugandan giant.
Undertaker, I know that you have never faced anybody as wild and unpredictable as Kamala, the Ugandan giant. But you're fixing to at SummerSlam. You've got yourself into a great situation.
I think Kamala missed one of his feedings. He was a little upset there.
Well, when he starts making noises, the way I understand him, you gotta feed him. If you don't feed him, you'll find something to eat, and it might be you.
Well, I think he just found out that he's gonna have to face The Undertaker.
I don't think that worries him. I don't think, huh? You know, The Undertaker hasn't shown any pain. He hasn't shown any emotion. He's just a cold, cold man.
I'll tell you, Brain, another knockdown, drag-out match. It's been signed for Wembley for SummerSlam. Shawn Michaels against the model Rick Martel. Two great superstars.
Great wrestlers, great technicians.
What a match that's
been. Like a winner there. How can you?
And let's not forget, still to come, that big interview between the Macho Man, Randy Savage, and his challenger at SummerSlam, the Ultimate Warrior. Well, he'll need a bigger bag at Wembley to stuff those three pieces of garbage in. Right now, let's take another look at Razor Ramon.
Wimbledon there with Kim Chi and Kamala.
Uh-oh.
Now, wait a minute.
This contest is scheduled for one fall.
Well, I believe we're going to have a collision here. There's only one aisle, to and from the dressing room.
Undertaker!
Uh-oh! On his way to the ring! Kamala on his way from the ring! They will meet at SummerSlam, but look at this!
Listen to the noise! Undertaker doesn't want any part of him!
That Undertaker has not taken one step backwards at all. He's simply holding his ground. Meanwhile, they're having great difficulty in getting Kamala away from the Undertaker. You see no fear in the eye of Kamala.
But you see the look of resolve, if in fact that's what you would describe, that look in the eyes of the Undertaker.
Well, that's just a little sampling of the electricity that we will feel when 80,000 fans who have jam-packed Wembley Stadium, they already have their tickets, it's sold out, and no doubt we will feel that electricity when The Undertaker squares off against Kamala.
Wow, what on a pay-per-view extravaganza. It's certainly the SummerSlam you thought you'd never see. This is a major part of it, The Undertaker against Kamala.
And we have been dwelling on the words of Harvey Whippleman, making reference to what Kamala was going to do after the match being over.
The dining, allegedly, Kamala was going to do.
Well, I don't know if you've heard the words of The Undertaker or not, but, well, they're not too appetizing. Let's leave it at that.
Yeah.
Making reference to worms and maggots and things of that nature. Things, I guess, that are, I guess, sort of fond to at least Paul Bearer. Nonetheless, what a matchup. Off the rope now and down to the canvas. Undertaker.
I can't help but to see the eyes of Kamala. He wanted the Undertaker right now.
He did. He did indeed. I mean, his eyes were so wide, and I don't believe he was afraid. Then again, maybe that was the look of fear. Way up high! And Duffy down to the canvas.
Maybe Kamala hasn't eaten yet today. Snack on the Undertaker.
I don't believe that will be the case, but you never can tell.
Uh-oh.
And if this happens to Kamala, if the Ugandan giant, is driven down to the canvas into the tombstone, then yes, you'll see the Undertaker victorious.
Wow.
Undertaker on his way to SummerSlam.
Much like you, Mr. Perfect, we just don't know in whose corner you're going to be at SummerSlam.
Well, I'll see you later, McMahon. I got some business to take care of. I'll be back in a bit.
What do you mean?
Where are you going? Mr. Perfect on his way out of here, and there you see The Undertaker putting the final finishing touches on Chris Duffy, his opposition in earlier.
There was the look. Undertaker. Ooh, look at that look as he looked at Kamala. Ooh.
ein weiterer Tag-Team-Kampf bevor, der fast nicht zu überbieten ist von der Besetzung her. Hier ist der erste der vier Männer. Wir werden uns Zeit lassen, mit der Vorstellung nichts vorwegnehmen. Hier auf jeden Fall sehen wir den Berserker mit Manager Mr. Fuji.
Here is the Berserker!
Und dieser Fan hat wohl seine eigene Meinung über den Berserker. Ja, wer wird der Partner dieses unberechenbaren Burschen sein, der behauptet, von den Wikingern abzustammen?
And his tag team partner, accompanied to the ring by his executive consultant, Mr. Perfect, weighing in at 242 pounds, unhailing from Charlotte, North Carolina. Wir werden abwarten müssen, wie lange es dauert, bis diese beiden oder diese vier Burschen fertig sind. Savage sieht sich natürlich sofort nach Flair um. Mr. Perfect macht ja vor kurzem sowohl dem Warrior als auch Savage ein Angebot, denjenigen beim SummerSlam zu managen, der ihm am meisten Geld bietet. Und weder der Warrior noch Savage haben eindeutig abgelehnt. Also für Spannung ist also auch von dieser Warte ausgesorgt. Und was sagt Flair dazu? Das ist ja auch nicht gerade uninteressant. Also der SummerSlam wird viele offene Fragen beantworten müssen. Denken Sie dran, am 31.08., also in 3 Tagen, ist es soweit. Dann übertragen wir den SummerSlam ab 21.05 Uhr.
Die Macht der Urne, jammert da Paul Bearer vor sich hin. Der Undertaker steht momentan alleine im Ring gegen den Berserker und Flair. Savage lässt über das Hallmikrofon sein berühmtes Oh yeah los und das Publikum reagiert sofort. Und Flair und Savage liefern sich die erwarteten verbalen Duelle.
Ja, das musste man erwarten. Diese beiden sind ja nicht nur hervorragende Wrestler, sondern auch Männer, die mit dem Mund umgehen können. Und hier, was haben wir da für eine Dame? Sehr hübsch, sehr elegant. Die Frage ist nur, für wen sie schwärmt.
Flair scheint für sein Team zu beginnen. Der Undertaker überlässt Savage das Feld. Das ist nett von ihm.
Ja, er hat wirklich eine vollkommene Kehrtwendung hinter sich.
Und Savage sprüht wieder mal vor Aktivität. Aber er sieht auch über die Schulter. Der Berserker könnte ja einen linken Trick versuchen. Und auch Mr. Fuji ist noch da.
Aber dann geht's doch wohl los. Nein, Flair war seinerseits noch nicht so weit. Savage versuchte es halt mal. Flair weiß wohl noch nicht so ganz genau, was er tun soll. Man sieht ihm förmlich an, wie er einen Plan ausheckt. An den Beinen des Undertaker vorbei. Und Savage holt sich die Unterstützung des Publikums. Das kann nicht schaden.
Und jetzt beginnen die beiden ein kleines Geplänkel. Und Flair scheint sich sehr wohl zu fühlen. Er ist ja auch einer der besten Wrestler der Welt eigentlich.
Absolut, ja. Einer der härtesten Arbeiter in der Geschichte des Wrestling überhaupt.
Jeder Lock und die beiden sind im Seil. Ich glaube, keiner der beiden wird jetzt einen unfairen Trick anbringen. Das haben sie auch nicht nötig. Zumindest nicht in dieser Phase des Kampfes. Flair wieder mit seinem Ruf. Savage sehr konzentriert und misstrauisch. Und gerade ist er nach vorne gestoßen, hat wohl etwas sehr spät. Er wirkt auf jeden Fall nervöser als Flair.
Wieder der Lock der beiden. Und der Side-Headlock von Savage. Aber Flair wird wohl gleich einen Whip-In zeigen. Nein. Er sagt den Standing Wrist Lock. Aber Savage befreit sich blitzschnell.
Und Flair steigt einfach aus dem Seil. Savage muss jetzt loslassen, aber er lässt sich Zeit. Dave Hebner soll ihn noch anzählen. Und mit einem Schlag in den Rücken von Flair verabschiedet sich Savage. Oh, aber Flair ist sauer, er will sich das nicht gefallen lassen. Nun die Provokation dabei. Eine Ohrfeige von Savage. Ich glaube, gleich macht Flair wirklich ernst.
Ja, es wundert mich, dass Slick Rick, wie Flair auch genannt wird, nicht schon explodiert ist. Doch er kann leicht seine Beherrschung verlieren. Ein grimmiger Blick des Nature Boy. Nicht des Originalen, aber doch des Zweiten. Aber erstaunlich groß ist seine Selbstbeherrschung, momentan zumindest.
Aber jetzt ist Savage nicht sonderlich beunruhigt. Aber jetzt geht's los. Ich glaube, jetzt hat's wirklich allen Ernstes begonnen, dieses absolute Top-Match. Whip-In! Shoulderblock, Flair geht zu Boden. Savage setzt nach. Hin und her geht es jetzt. Ein Clothesline von Savage. Und sofort schickt er den Undertaker rein. Flair hat sofort gemerkt, dass er jetzt nicht gut für ihn aussieht. Er weicht zurück.
Ja, ich verstehe gar nicht, warum er nicht einfach mit dem Berserker wechselt. Er kann ihn doch leicht erreichen. Und der Berserker will natürlich rein. Machtzeichen. Perfect und Fuji schauen besorgt rein. Flair schlägt zu und zwar so fest er kann, aber das nutzt überhaupt nichts. Dieser kleine Flair, knapp unter 1,80 ist er groß. Eine Schlagserie, doch der Undertaker zuckt noch nicht mal mit den Wimpern.
Flair ist jetzt offensichtlich nicht mehr wohl in seiner Haut. Aber da hat er zugestochen. Der Undertaker ist überrascht und Flair mit dem Whip-In. Zumindest versucht er es, aber der Undertaker hält einfach fest, lässt sich nicht wegziehen. Reversal! Und locker hebt der Undertaker Flair hoch. Lange hält er ihn oben. Was für eine Kraft. Wahnsinn. Und krachend geht es auf den Boden.
Aber da wäre der Undertaker mit dem Schwung fast selbst mitgestürzt. Erneut der Whip-In. Und noch einmal dieser Kraftakt. Da zeigt sich wieder, über welche titanischen Kräfte der Undertaker verfügt. Jetzt erst wechselt Flair. Der Berserker stürmt sofort auf den Undertaker los und er kann ihn offenbar beeindrucken. Aber beide treffen jetzt ziemlich genau, sind in etwa gleich stark.
Aber der Undertaker scheint sich ja doch den Vorteil sichern zu können. Der Berserker zappelt in der Ecke. Er kann sich nicht wehren. Natürlich ist das ein regelwidriger Würgegriff gewesen eben. Der kleine Dave Hebner zählt auch fleißig an. Aber er will dem Undertaker nicht zu nahe kommen. Man weiß ja nie, wie der reagiert. Das gilt aber auch für den Berserker eigentlich.
Genau, ja. Aber momentan der Undertaker nur mit einem verächtlichen Blick. Flair ist schon wieder da. Aber er will den Undertaker wohl nur ablenken, damit der Berserker sich ausruhen und vielleicht einen hinterhältigen Angriff starten kann. Doch der Berserker ist zu fertig. Whip-in vom Undertaker.
Oh, aber da prallt er auf den ausgestreckten Fuß des Berserkers. Und nun dreht der auf. Anlauf. Und der Tritt schickt den Undertaker übers Seil. Hat man sowas schon gesehen, aber er bleibt stehen. Der Berserker ist schon wieder da. Aber der Undertaker greift sein Bein und zieht ihn raus.
Ja, und sofort muss der Berserker weiter einstecken. Ein harter Schlag. Ein Headbutt auf die Treppe. Den haben wir heute auch schon oft genug gesehen. Und gleich noch einer. Und dann geht der Berserker zu Boden. Dave Hebner zählt schon die ganze Zeit, ist wirklich sauer auf beide. Aber momentan scheint er vor allen Dingen sauer auf den Undertaker zu sein. Aber der achtet nicht darauf und schiebt den Berserker wieder zurück.
Oh, hier hat er daneben geschlagen. Und der Undertaker zieht ihm das Bein weg, der Berserker mit einem Spagat. Na, da sage noch einer, dieser Riesen seien nicht gelenkig. Der Undertaker hat den Berserker völlig unter Kontrolle jetzt. Und hier der Werkster mit Savage.
Der steigt sofort aufs Seil. Und er wechselt mit dem Double Axe Handle Blow. Der hat getroffen. Sofort das Cover. Aber Mr. Perfect greift ein. Das hätte er aber gar nicht gemusst. Der Berserker kommt auch so raus. Und da überrascht der Savage mit dem Headbutt. Ja, nun sieht es für den Champion nicht so gut aus.
Flair sieht jetzt zufrieden aus. Kaum ist Savage oben, greift Flair zu. Ringrichter ist bei Perfect. Der Berserker bei Fuji. Aber der Undertaker setzt sich in Bewegung. Nun ist Hebner bei ihm. Und der Berserker kann sich über Savage hermachen. Das tut er mit wachsender Begeisterung. Wenn man sich vorstellt, wie groß Savage ist und wie klein er im Vergleich zum Berserker wird, erst dann erkennt man die Ausmaße des Berserkers richtig.
Der Whip-In soll das wohl werden. Nein, der Berserker bleibt bei seiner Brutalo-Taktik. In der eigenen Ecke macht er den Macho Man regelrecht fertig. Und schaut er auf Flair. Und es kommt der Wechsel. Flair kann sich nun über den angeschlagenen Macho Man hermachen. Über einen wehrlosen Gegner fällt er am liebsten her.
Whip in. Und ein klatschender Schlag an den Hals. Sofort das Cover. Aber Savage kommt dann nochmal raus. Hier der Reverse Chinlock. Flair will Savage nun die Luft rauben. Scheint ihm auch zu gelingen, aber er ist wieder rausgekommen. Hier noch ein Armdreher. Wieder der Wechsel. Und auch der Berserker wechselt mit dem Tritt in die Seite. Und dann fährt er seinen mächtigen Stiefel aus und drückt Savage fast durch den Ringpfosten nach draußen.
Ja, Savage fällt nun aus dem Ring. Er müsste jetzt wechseln, doch momentan kann ihm das nie und immer gelingen. Mr. Perfect greift auch noch ein. Der Berserker hat Hebner abgelenkt, wie wir in dieser Einstellung gesehen haben. Dann aber ist er wieder bei Savage. Es läuft nicht gut für den WWF-Champion.
Oh, nun landet Savage da, wo vorher der Berserker hin musste. Mr. Perfect greift ein. Es geht hier so schnell, dass Hebner gar nicht mitkommen kann. Randy Savage jetzt in allergrößten Schwierigkeiten. Und ob der Undertaker nun darauf brennt, mit ihm zu wechseln oder ob er einfach nur abwartet, das kann man gar nicht sagen. Dafür ist er viel zu unterkühlt. Und der Berserker will natürlich hier den Sack zumachen. Es sieht so aus, als könne ihm das auch gelingen.
Und Savage landet erneut auf der Matte außerhalb des Rings. Ja, der Berserker wird seinem Namen voll gerecht und Flair kann sich jetzt natürlich leicht auf die Treppe stellen und Savage verspotten. Und nichts ist für einen Topmann wie Savage schlimmer, als so gedemütigt zu werden. Der Undertaker ist inzwischen im Ring, er hat es auf den Berserker abgesehen. Der Hebner versucht verzweifelt, die Verordnung zu sorgen. Und der Undertaker scheint tatsächlich um Randy Savage besorgt zu sein.
Aber er ist bei Flair, will sich diesen kleinen Wicht zumindest in seinen Augen vornehmen. Der Besorger steigt unbemerkt aus dem Ring und kann nun Savage weiter fertig machen. Auch Dave Hebner ist abgelenkt und nun räumt der Besorger sogar die Matte vom Boden weg. Erinnern Sie sich, das hat er auch beim Undertaker in dem denkwürdigen Match gemacht, das die Feindschaft dieser beiden begründete. Es sieht übel aus, oh Gott, Savage. Ein Bodyslam auf den harten Boden. Und da freut sich der Berserker so richtig.
Der Savage ist jetzt am Ende. Ich weiß nun auch nicht mehr, wie man ihm helfen könnte. Wenn er wechseln will, muss er in den Ring und zum Undertaker gelangen. Doch davon ist er meilenweit entfernt. Er liegt sogar unter der Matte. Mr. Perfect legt sich mit dem Publikum an. Ansonsten hat die Action den Nullpunkt erreicht. Sehen Sie nur, wie leidenschaftlich die Fans Savage anfeuern. Der Undertaker ist wieder in seiner Ecke und der Berserker weiter am Macho Man dran.
Aber Savage ist jetzt wieder im Ring. Der Berserker legt ihn sich zurecht, er klemmt den Macho Man fest und da hat er natürlich leichtes Spiel. Und wieder jubelt der Berserker. Nun nimmt der Anlauf, wie es zu erwarten war. Oh, aber Savage bringt das Bein hoch, stoppt den Berserker. Nun krabbelt er so schnell es geht zum Undertaker rüber. Der Wechsel gelingt, also es wundert mich wirklich, wie schnell er nun doch beim Undertaker war. Und der lag natürlich mit seiner ganzen Wut im Bauch los. Der Berserker ist ja noch schon lange im Ring, kann nichts entgegensetzen. Whippin und dann der hohe Flying Clothesline vom Undertaker.
Da kommt jetzt sein Tombstone wie gewohnt nach dieser Aktion. Schläge an den Kopf. Und jawohl, da ist der Ansatz zum Tombstone gar nicht so leicht bei diesem riesigen Berserker. Aber er gelingt. Und nun meldet sich Flair zurück. Aber den befördert der Undertaker mit einem Clothesline raus. Und nun noch ein Wechsel mit Savage. Der Undertaker will wohl dem Champion den Triumph des Covers überlassen. Eine sehr faire Geste. Smash und das Cover. Jawohl, auch Perfect rettet nichts mehr. Dieser Kampf ist gelaufen. Und vielleicht sehen wir heute zum ersten Mal freundschaftliche Gesten zwischen Savage und dem Undertaker. Mit diesen Bildern nach einem ungeheuer spannenden Kampf wollen wir uns für heute verabschieden. Und denken Sie dran, am kommenden Montagabend um 21.05 Uhr, also dem 31.08., zeigen wir den SummerSlam. Nicht verpassen. Tschüss, bis dann.